Husain Dada was my paternal grandfather. My father was the second oldest of his six kids. And it's me and my sister, and my parents live in Delhi. We moved to Dubai, my husband and me and my daughter, around 5 years back. And after coming here, we had two more kids. But my granddad was very close to my kids and all his other grandchildren with Bombay, and he had his grandchildren here in Dubai as well. And sometimes he would call up and say, I'm 15 minutes away and make this for me to eat and I'll be there. Sometimes he would just come unannounced, and he had the peculiar way of ringing the doorbell. He used to do it like twice, and we all knew that, okay, Dada's here. So the kids would come running from upstairs and we would like all assemble here.
तुम्हारा उवेश और तुम्हारी हिम्मत रात दिन रात तुम्हारे साथ है, और मेरे दिन और मेरी रातें ज्यादातर घर से बाहर.
My granddad made a couple of paintings while he was in this house as well. He loved to have people around, and when I would say that should I send the kids upstairs, he would say that no, let the kids run around, I want to see them playing, and they would be all over him and jumping on his canvas and trying to do their stuff, and he would say let them be. He's 2 years old, Jahan, and he loved his name, and he's written on the side, Sare Jahan Se Acha, Jahan Hamara.
Jaise tumhari aadat mujhe bahut pyari lagi, ki tum अपने डैडी को उवेस कहकर बुलाते. काश मेरे बेटे बेटियां भी मकबूल मकबूल कहकर पुकारती, कानों को कितना अच्छा लगता. ये क्या बाबा 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 बाबा, ये क्या बाबा बाबा, ये क्या ऐसे सुनाई देता है जैसे बाबा ब्लैक शीप हैवी एनी रूल. तो मैं जवाब दूं, नो सर नो सर, कीप योर कूल, आई एम एन इंडियन नॉट अ फूल.
He got along very well with my older one, and they even painted together around 5 years back in London. She was drawing, and he said to bring the canvas to him, and when she took it to him, he said, okay, you draw and I'll paint. The painting that he did with my daughter in London. My son was very small, I think he was around 6 months old. But my middle one, she used to always imitate the way he walked, and she really enjoyed looking at him, and she would always ask me, why does Big Nana not wear any shoes? And she would always keep looking at his feet, and she would try and draw, you know, Big Nana without any shoes. And he spent quite a lot of time with us here. He was an early riser. And one incident I remember, 2 years ago, we were traveling together, we were in London, and we were staying in the same apartment, and I wanted to sleep in, and there I heard some sounds in the kitchen. It was I think around 5 o'clock in the morning, and he was trying to make his tea, you know, and he would have his tea and begin painting. And he liked music, he liked to listen to music also very often. He liked Fairs, Ahmed Fairs, the poetry. He liked some particular songs from the Jodha Akbar, Khwaja Mere Khwaja. But it was regardless whether there was music or no music, or the room had no furniture, those things somehow never mattered to him. And once he started painting, he was so immersed in it. And there were times when he was doing these huge canvases, you know, 7 feet, 10 feet. And he would be crawling literally all over the canvas and painting. And he would be lost to the world. This was a Ganesh that a friend of mine had commissioned, and he was doing this for me, and I fell in love with it because he rarely does those kind of flowers that he's done around it. And one strange thing is, all my life I've never really asked him for a painting, you know. That kind of relationship I didn't have enough courage or whatever to ask him, Dada, can you give me a painting? But when he made this, I totally fell in love with it, and he saw it on my face, and he was like, achhi lagi? I said, haan. He said, theek hai, rakh lo. So I immediately went and got it framed, because in case he changed his mind. He did it really fast, maybe like around an hour, and it was all done. And he was very interested in movies. So certain movies watched 50 times, 40 times. We saw, the last one I saw with him was Rab Ne Bana Di Jodi. And we saw that together 4 times, and then I was like, I cannot see it, you know. He was like, nahin, nahin, phir se chalenge. I was like, no. He was very easygoing, and it was a very, like, everything would just flow, you know. It wasn't like, okay, at 1 o'clock I have to have my lunch and 4 o'clock is tea.
Initially, he used to tell me about this time when he was sitting and having tea with some of his friends, and he told them, acha, I'm just going to be back in 10 minutes. And he stepped out that day, and he called them up only after 11 days. So even when he had to meet people, you know, you never knew till he actually reached there.
This is around 28 years old. It's called the Blue Tiger. I remember him making this painting. He sat at where we lived in Jankura at that time in Delhi, and he painted there. And I came back from school, and he was in the middle of the painting. He said, "I'm making this specially for you." Somehow even the kids love it because of all the colors. My daughter wanted to have it in her room because of how colorful it is. He loved his fast cars, and he had the great knowledge about, you know, cars, and he knew what engine, what horsepower, this, that. He knew everything, and he wanted the best, and he would like go swipe his card and, you know, buy himself a car. And he was quite a woman's man. when I was a child, I really didn't know that my granddad was very famous, and and there were canvases always in the house, since my dad is also an artist. So the first time I actually got to know that he was really famous was when he had a bypass in Delhi, which was around 23 years ago. We were in hospital, and it was a family thing, and suddenly I see Rajiv Gandhi walking in with all the security, you know. And that's the time I slowly began to understand that, okay, he's not just my dada, he also happens to be one of the most famous artists. And this is a sculpture of him done by my dad when my dad was in college. And these are some drawings of different artists. My dad, whenever he went on artist's camp, he would get little sketches made for my daughter, Saisha. So then you have Lakshma Gaur, you have Suhas Roy making all these little drawings for him. And my dad, Shamshad Hussain, he does a lot of figures, and earlier his work was all in muted shades, and he used a lot of browns. It's recently that he started using a lot of color. And this was again when he was staying with me 2 years back. He made this, and I loved it. I love the... There's just so much happening in this canvas, you know. They're talking, and there's some action this side, and I love the different colors that he's used. And his style was very different from my granddad's. He always signs as Shamshad. He never says Hussain, you know. And he left home at 16. He never wanted to be under his father's shadow. This painting, it's a watercolor that he did for me. This is again 1984 in London. It was one of our holidays. We had gone in the summer, and I used to really like birds, and he said, okay, I'll make you a dove. This is another of my dad's works. I love the different tones of brown and gold, dull gold. And he is a self-made man, completely. Yeah. This is my daughter's room, so it's got one wall of One Direction, the band that she really likes these days. And the other wall has drawings that my granddad and my dad have made for her. And most of them have things like Sweet Saisha written, and From Your Big Nana. There's some very interesting ones. This is of him himself holding a canvas with a horse galloping out. And they used to call him Big Nana, so a lot of them said, From Your Big Nana. And this almost looks very childlike. It was like she drew this, but it's actually him. He did this for her. And these three are done by my dad. This is of Saisha herself when she had a fringe, and this one is her table with her bag and her chair, and that is my dad. This is when I was expecting my daughter, and so I was in the hospital going in for delivery. She was born at 9:30, and here the clock shows that it's already 9. He made this just before I was wheeled out. He loved eating out, though he didn't eat much. His appetite was very small, but he was very passionate about food, and he would describe food in such a way also that you would want to eat it, you know. He loved my mom's cooking. He loved her Shami kebabs. So she would send that from India. And as much as he liked to eat in fancy restaurants, he was equally at ease, and he loved the food at roadside dhabas. And Nizamuddin in Delhi was one place he'd go to. In Bombay, there was a particular place he used to go to for chai. It was called Double Doodh Pani Kam. So he used to love that milky tea. He always liked to have tea in a glass. You would never see him having in a mug or a cup. It was always these small glasses. And he loved to dip his rumali roti in that and eat. And in Dubai, I think a few of his favorite restaurants were the Noodle House at Emirates Stars. He liked Al Nafura a lot. I would give him company eating because I'm not such a good cook. In London, he loved the Royal China. And my husband took him to Royal China just, I think, 3-4 days before he passed away. They had lunch there.
You know, when I got married, and it was just, I think, I had been married like a week or so, and he met us, and he asked my husband, "Toh kaise chal raha hai?" And Jatin was like, "It's going good, and everything's good." So he's like, "What do you mean? You haven't fought?" So we said, "No." So he's like, "Arey, ladoge nahi toh fir maza kya hai? If you don't fight and you're just happy and enjoying life, that's boring."
This is a print on canvas. He had done a series of those as well, and those are, there are some of them, I think this is around 5 feet something. There are some which are 7 feet, 6 feet. And they look really stunning. He would sound a bit melancholic was when he would talk about his mother. His childhood, she was never there because she passed away very early.
नाम है मेरा मकबूल सिर्फ घर की चार दीवारी चार दीवारी लेकिन बाहर एमए हुसैन बना सकता चारों तरफ मेरा चर्चा है मेरी कहानियां मगर मोहम्मद मुद्दार मैं चाहता हूं कि तुमसे कुछ और बातें जो औरों को कहना भूल गया हो सकता है अगर मेरी माँ जिंदा होती तो उसे जरूर कुछ सब कुछ बता देता।
And even there are a lot of paintings that he's done of his mother, and that's the only time maybe I saw him sad. Otherwise, my God, if anybody was depressed, they just needed to spend 5 minutes with him, and depression would be like out of the window. So he loved his family, and if everyone got together, that gave him a lot of joy. The kids running around and everyone chatting and eating, and I think for him, his family was the most important. My granddad was painting the Ramayana, and he wanted to tell us about it. So one day while sitting here, he made this little sketch, and these were actually huge canvases. I think more than like 6 feet, 7 feet each canvas. And he tried to show us, you know, he made a sketch and showed us what it would actually look like and what he was planning to do.
Art for him somehow wasn't only limited to the canvas. He was interested in colors in more ways, like in clothes, and he was interested in films. He was interested in food, cinema. So there was just so much that appealed to him. He did like works of other artists as well, some of his contemporaries, and he even had a show with Picasso. And Sadiqan and he, they were friends, and there was a time in Delhi, they both were sitting together and they decided to paint for one another. So my granddad did a portrait of Sadiqan, and he did a portrait of my granddad, and they exchanged the paintings. And he was very approachable, and wherever he went, people walked up to him, he spoke to them, and he never had anything about him, the way he was or the way he spoke or the way he looked, that, you know, he had these airs about him. He was, I think, one of the most simple people. Even his, he had no demands in life, even. He was one of the simplest men I knew. Yes, he did have he loved his fast cars, expensive cars. He liked good clothes. He loved to shop at these big brands and stuff. But other than that, he was quite simpleton at heart. My granddad never really sort of gave advice and said, you know, that this is the way to live life and this is what you should do. He never did that.
The last time I met my granddad, I think it was a month before he died, and it was here in Dubai. And I spoke to him, I think, just a day before he passed away. Dada was very free-spirited. He had a lot of childlike qualities in him. You know, anybody who met my granddad, whether it was me or someone who was meeting him for the first time, and even if it meant spending just 5 minutes with him, you would get up feeling like, okay, you had this encounter with someone who's infused life and energy into you. And he was like an awesome man. So, and somehow, you know, I think not only to me, to the world, he was immortal. So I never really felt, you know, that he would ever die, even though he was 96, 95. And even at that time, when I spoke to him the last, he said, "Acha, main soch raha hu 100th birthday pe aise karenge, puri family yahan jayegi." And he had lots of stories to tell. So even though he was in hospital and he wasn't well, I don't think even he thought that, you know, those were his last couple of days. So for me, immortal is what my granddad was and will be.
Faja mere faja, dil mein samaja, shaah ka shaatu, ali ka dulara.